we have a relationship to where we have really good communication. So I'm like, Justin, this is what you're doing. He's like, why are we doing that? How come we're doing this? Well, who's doing this? I don't want to do that. I want to do this. You know, he has an opinion.
And I'm going up while this is playing. That's why I want.
Yeah. Justin wants to make sure the lighting is right. He wants to make sure the music sounds right. The stage is right. The dancers are right. He wants to be a part of everything.
I went to his house one day, right? He played me like 30 ideas that he did. Like, you know, just sitting in his house and his laptop playing me all these ideas.
Listen to this. That's yeah. Jazz laughing.
Yeah. And I told him, I said, one day you're gonna produce your own album. One day. Because he has it in him. He has, the gift is in him. You know, and people can say what they wanna say about that guy. The kid is talented.
I see this. This is what's so crazy is that this is just the previews of an amazing movie that's about to happen.
About what? What do you see your future movie being about?
I'm talking about this is just. I'm so happy to know that this is the beginning.
He hasn't got to his Thriller.
I haven't got, bro. This is like Jackson 5. Like. I released Baby, I released Beauty and the Beat, I released Then You Heard As Long As You Love Me, you were like, okay, who is this kid? And where is he going?
When I first heard As Long As You Love Me, we were at Rodney Jerkins' studio. Immediately, it's like, when it drops into the chorus. And Justin's like, you know, we're all bumping around the room, and it's like, immediately, you just know.
Yeah.
Oh, listen to that.
It was 140 BPMs and it was real fast. And it was really like that. But sometimes you get inspired and you hear it differently. And I felt like it needed to lean a little bit dubstep. It needed to be halftime to create more emotion.
Just take my hand. What's that?
And he just wanted to get in that booth. And he actually was a little under the weather when he recorded that.
Just take. I got it. Just take my hand. Just take my hand.
Most of the time stuff like that happens, I'll stop the session. And I'll be like, let's do it another time. You don't feel 100%. But he was in his zone, man. You can't stop his zone.
I'll be a soldier, fighting every second of the day for your dreams, girl.
Listen. That day? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Play that day real quick.
It's crazy.
Oh, my God. If Vibrato were that day.
Fighting every second of the day for your dreams, girl.
It's little inflections, little runs that he does in his voice. 7 billion people in this world trying to fit in. It's like, it's how he releases things. It's how he stays on certain notes. I mean, a lot of people can sing that, but they'd probably sing it, we're under pressure. 7 million people in the world trying to fit in. It's like, there's nothing special about that, but he has a certain attack. He has a certain inflection that's really special that only he can do.
In all false notes.
Okay. You know what I mean? During this album, Justin turned 18. So one of the things I was concerned about was the falsetto part. When he goes, as long as you la 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 la. Like we were, I was like, oh my God.
Okay.
There was a moment there for like 2 months where he literally could not hit a falsetto note. And I used to go, and I can't sing for crap. But Justin could not hit that note and it used to drive him crazy.
I got you.
You know, he got in the box and I was like, all right.
As long as you la 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 me.
He was going for it and going for it. You know, sometimes you're just like, maybe we should just come back and get it another time. Not with him. He's gonna stay there until he gets it.
Justin.
greatness will go finish something. Even when it doesn't feel like you're 100%, you'll give it all you have. It's the equivalent to being on stage sick and you throw up, but you're still performing. It's the equivalent to Michael Jackson on the Soul Train Awards dancing in a wheelchair. Greatness. You don't stop. You just go. In a world so cold, here's a path that I've chosen. Here's a heart that ain't frozen. You feel the tears from my soul. And see the pain in these rains, man. I push up window panes and hold it in like it ain't no thing. And I just want you to know that I want us to be amazing. Justin did a rap before we put Big Sean on it. Justin rapped on it. And the crazy thing about that was, he didn't write it. He went in the booth and he freestyled. And it just came out of him. And I was just like, I didn't even know he could do that. They should bring that back. They should put it out again with his rap on it or something.
Everyone said, As Long As You Love Me is a risk. That's the record that's either gonna go all the way or not go at all. And Justin was very adamant. He was sure it would go all the way. And he was right. As Long As You Love Me was his first radio number one. And just took him to the next level, because radio is very 25 and up driven. And to go number one to that audience showed that he was no longer just some teen act. As long as you love, la, la, la.
We could be starving, we could be hoping, we could be broken.